Hi guys, today I'm going to show you our new instruction called Request Approval. This allows you to have it so that your technicians or whoever's doing task can now send the task off to be approved by a supervisor or QA or whoever you want to make sure that the task was actually performed correctly. Additionally, it allows you to even break apart the task so you could have the first couple instructions done by one person. Once that's done, they send it off for approval to the next person, and then they can continue on with the task with the next, five instructions, for example. So anyways, I'll show you how this works. And to do that, over here, I'm logged in as Brian as a technician. And so I would come in, go do my different steps, and then request the approval from Daryl. And I'll go ahead and set this. Limble actually detects I haven't logged time, so I'm gonna really quickly log an hour, and then I'll go ahead and request approval from Daryl. Now over here, this is the manager screen, and you'll see as soon as I refresh this, this sample work order is now assigned to Daryl. I pop this open and I can see all of the steps that Brian did and see if this is something I want to approve or not. If it's good, I'll go ahead and sign my name, so Daryl, and then click approve. If it's incorrect and I don't like it, I can actually click disapprove and provide a reason. So the work wasn't good enough. Now a couple things happen when you disapprove it. First and foremost, notifications go out back to Brian, the original person, letting them know that the task was disapproved. Additionally, the reason why it was disapproved will be put straight in this instruction, and that technician then can go back, correct the steps, and then request approval again. In this case, let's go through and say that I fixed the problem, and now I'll request Daryl to approve it again. And then it's the same workflow over here. Now it's assigned back to Daryl. Daryl can go ahead and look at this and see, all right, now the steps look like they're completed correctly. So let's go ahead and sign my name. And then click approve. Now, since this was the last step in this task, it'll immediately pop up the complete task. Daryl will verify that this is all right. And then go ahead and click and complete to close it out. Now that that's done, it's no longer in my list of things to do, and I can move on to the next thing. Furthermore, what's great about this instruction is that you can chain tasks together, and I'm going to build this out really quick so you can see what I mean. So we'll go ahead and do step one, step two, we'll add a request approval, and then we'll go ahead and say, I want Daryl to approve that again, and then I want a couple steps for Daryl to do. Now with this built this way, you'll see that when I go ahead and start this, these items afterwards are grayed out. They cannot be completed until the request approval has been done by Daryl. And so this is a way to segment different work for different users all within the same task. So for example, if I was logged in on Brian on this screen, I would need to do step one, step two, send it to Daryl. Daryl would then approve those steps. So we'll actually go ahead and do that. Daryl will look at these steps, actually approve it, and then these items open up for Daryl to actually finish. And so this is a good way to chain instructions to different people inside the same task. Anyways, this is the new feature. Thank you for taking the time to watch. If you have any questions or need any help, as always, please feel free to reach out in the chat window. It's down here in the bottom right, or of course, leave any comments below, and we're most definitely here to help. Thank you very much, and you have a great day.